Now, today we start about the construction and definition and principle operation of DC machine. DC machine is an energy conversion device. It converts energy from one form of to another. It is of two types. One is called the DC generator and second is called the DC motor. A DC generator is a machine which converts mechanical energy or power into electrical energy or power. In second hand, a DC motor is a machine which converts electrical energy or power into mechanical energy or power. Construction of DC machine. DC machine consists of a stator and rotor. Stator is the stationary part and the rotor is the rotating part of DC machine. In DC machine, the field winding on the stator and the armature winding on the rotor. This is the construction of DC machine. This has the field winding, the commutator, the armature conductors, shaft, commutator segments, interpoles, frame or yoke, and pole shoe or pole core. Here the construction, clear construction. This is the shaft on which the DC rotor rotates. Now first we discuss about the stator. The stator consists of the yoke made of unlaminated ferromagnetic material. The salient field poles bolted to the inner periphery of the yoke, field winding, interpoles, compensating winding, brushes, brush holders and bearings. These are the stationary part of the DC machine. Yoke kya hai? The yoke rests on the supporting base and is made of cast iron. For small machines, in large machines, the yoke is made of fabricated steel, which has higher permeability than cast iron. The yoke has two functions. One function is it provides the path for the pole flux phi and carry half of it, that means phi upon 2. Second, it provides mechanical support for the poles and acts as a protecting cover for the whole machine. Field poles. The field poles poles are made of a stack of steel plates 1 to 1.5 mm thick, riveted together. It consists of pole cores and pole shoes. Dekhe, do cheez lagta hai. The pole core is made of cast steel, but the pole shoe or pole face is laminated and fixed to the pole cores appropriately. In present day practice, both pole core and pole shoe are made from the thin lamination of sheet steel to reduce the ready current losses. The pole core where the field poles is wound is usually of a small cross section than the pole shoe due to the following reason. To reduce cross section of the pole core required less copper of the field winding. And second, the large pole shoe area increases the flux pole entering the armature due to the reduction in the air gap reactance. And third, pole shoe provides mechanical strength and support to the field winding. This is the main function of the pole shoe. Now we come to the field winding. Field winding is made of, there is a written of the numbers, construction of field winding. The field winding consists of copper wire or strip wound around the pole shoe. Hai na? The number of turns and cross section of field winding depend upon the type of DC machines as under. For DC shunt machine, thin wire of large number of turns and small cross section are used. For DC series motor, thick wire of small number of turns and large cross sections are used. For DC compound machine, both shunt ko hum thin wire se use karte hain, series field winding is used of thick wire. Interpoles, these are fixed to the yoke in between the main poles of a DC machine and these are usually tapered with the sufficient sectional area at the root to avoid the magnetic saturation. And its function is to compensate the armature reaction, to neutralize the armature reaction. Now the next is the compensating winding. These winds are placed in the slot cut the pole faces of a DC machine. So compensation was also connected in series with the armature circuit, and it also used to neutralize the armature reaction of a DC machine. Now the brushes, bearing brush holders and bearings, the brushes whose function is to collect the current from the commutator are usually made of carbon or graphite and are in the shape of rectangular block. The brushes are housed in the box type brush holders attached to the stator yoke. A small spring keeps the brushes pressed on the commutator surface. So these are the main difference all about the construction of DC machine.